Let us perform a small experiment. Take a bottle and fill it half with water. Mark the level of water in the bottle. Now place it in a freezer. Allow entire water to convert into ice. Observe. Is the level of ice same as that of the water level which we had marked? The level is not same, and we also observe that it has increased. That is, when water is converted to ice, its volume increases. Now take a glass of water. Keep it in the refrigerator. Remove it after 10-15 minutes. Observe. Is ice formed uniformly? Is it formed only at bottom or is it formed only at the top? We observe a light film of ice at the top. No ice is formed at the lower level. We conclude that water starts converting to ice from top. Normally, when a substance is cooled, its density increases and volume decreases. But water does not obey this rule. Water behaves abnormally and hence it is called anomalous behavior of water. Let us see what is this anomalous behavior of water. When water at normal temperature starts cooling, its density increases like that of most liquids.
When temperature of water falls below 4 degrees Celsius, its density starts decreasing and volume starts increasing. So, instead of contracting, water expands when temperature of water falls below 4 degrees Celsius. This abnormal behavior of water of expanding when cooled below 4 degrees Celsius is called anomalous behavior of water. So, lakes and rivers freeze in winter as temperature goes on falling below 0 degrees Celsius. Water at 4 degrees Celsius has maximum density, so it forms the lower layer. As the temperature falls further, it is converted to ice and forms the upper layer as the density of ice is less and floats on water. Also, when water is converted to ice, it expands and seals all the boundaries and hence forming an insulating layer. This further stops the temperature of lower layers from falling down. Water at lower level still remains at 4 degrees Celsius and does not freeze, which helps in aquatic life remaining alive.
That is how penguins eat fish by breaking the layer of ice. Why is it easier to swim in the sea than in a well or a lake? Take 2 glasses of water A and B. Add 3 to 4 spoonfuls of salt to water in B. Dissolve it completely. Now put a lemon in glass A. Observe. Remove that lemon. Wipe it with a cloth and put it in glass B. Observe. Note down your observations. Lemon sinks in glass A and lemon floats in glass B. Why? When we added salt in glass B, the density of water increases due to dissolved salt in it. Same thing happens in seawater. Density of seawater is more than the well or lake water. Hence, it is easier to swim in seawater. In the previous activity, when we added salt, we could see the particles of salt. But after stirring, we see that salt particles disappeared. Why does this happen? Salt particles spread in water and they become smaller and smaller. Then they become so small that we cannot even see them. This means that they have completely mixed with water. That is, homogeneous mixture is formed. The process is called dissolving. And a mixture of salt and water is called a solution. In this case, it is a salt solution. Salt is the substance that mixes or dissolves, hence it is called solute. Water is the substance in which salt dissolves. It is called solvent. Water is a universal solvent as many substances dissolve in it. Water is also used for cleaning, like bathing, washing. Water helps in cooling. Hence, it is a good coolant and used in motor vehicles to cool the temperature of the engine. Due to the property of fluidity of water, it is used for water transport and to generate electricity.